welcome back to Success Digest Show with Abrahams. Today I decided that I was going to show you guys something different, especially for those of us who are new into cryptocurrency trading and are a bit confused about, you know, what platform to use, what currency to trade on, what coin to buy, what to do. You know, whenever you want to start out your cryptocurrency trading, you know, project, sometimes it's always a bit difficult to kickstart this thing, you know, just like how it works with other professions out there, other projects out there. You know, the beginning stage is usually sometimes confusing, difficult, you know, it's just name it. Sometimes it's just so complicated that you don't really know where to start from. So I got a lot of questions from some of my friends who truly want to go into cryptocurrency trading, asking me on how they are gonna get started, from what currency to buy, when to buy, when not to buy, how to know a potential a cryptocurrency with potential. You know, all these things are things you got to understand while you make more research, while you start trading, when you start doing the practical things in cryptocurrency trading. But I just decided to create this short video to show you guys the five most important things you should know before starting your cryptocurrency. It's true that, okay, selecting an exchange is one of the most important things, though I'm not going to be covering that area today, but I decided that virtually everything we're going to be talking about here in this video is concerning the Bittrex platform, because Bittrex is one of those trusted exchanges out there, aside from Bitfinex, Poloniex, and a whole lot of them out there. So, but let's get to work. If you want to start your cryptocurrency trading, you know, business project, there are five important things you should know, especially if you want to use the Bittrex platform. Of course, everybody craves for, you know, maximum security, and Bittrex is one of those trusted platforms where you can actually trade securely without having this fear that, oh my god, all your money will get lost, you know, hackers are gonna hack into your account someday and, you know, steal all your cryptos, and, you know, you're just gonna be like stranded on the way. So my topic today is like five important things to know before trading on the Bittrex.com platform. So, like we all know, creating an account on Bittrex, it's the most important thing you should do. You just have to go there to bittrex.com, sign up, you know, fill the blah 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 there, your name, your password, and, you know, but just make sure in the first the beginner stage you just want to be sure that your password is, you know, fully secured. It's a kind of password that, you know, it's not easy for people to guess or something like that. So, and then be sure that your password it's unique, not like a password you use on other platforms like your Gmail account, your Yahoo, you know, your Facebook and other social media networks. So be sure that your password is so unique, because it adds to your credit and your security. So when you get to the Bittrex platform and you log in, as you can see here, it's telling me to log out, which means I'm already logged in. So when you get onto the Bittrex platform, this is the first thing you see on the home page. You know, the Bittrex, when you click on the bittrex.com and wait, allows it to load. After loading, this is, you know, this is the first thing you see. This is actually the home page. It's gonna be telling it's mostly the update on, you know, the highest, the most, you know, well-to-do cryptocurrencies in the market. So you can see we have AntShares, we have Ethereum, Sphera, IDMI, Agoras. This is telling you that AntShares is one of the cryptocurrencies with the highest volume, followed by Ethereum, you know, Sphere, IDMI, Agoras, and so on and so forth. Then it's showing you the Bitcoin market, Bitcoin to Ethereum, ETH market, Bitcoin, ANTS, there's for ANTS shares, Bitcoin, SNT. All these are actually abbreviations for all these different currencies. And with time, I'm positive enough that you will come to understand all these, you know, abbreviations and actually the crypto the token names. So when you log into your platform, the most important thing you should always and would always want to do is to come to the settings area. the settings area loads up, and then this is where most of the things you need to do on the Bittrex platform begins. You know, you just have to be sure you go through all these basic verifications, phone verification, enhanced verification, password, two-factor authentication, and so on and so forth. Seriously, okay, let's just take them one by one. The basic verification, where you click on it, it's like, you know, gonna pop out a page telling you, you know, showing you the information you filled when you started, you know, in the when you are at the sign up stage, then followed by the phone verification. You see, it's already telling me that, okay, your phone has been verified. Thank you for providing your contact number. This is most important because, you know, sometimes some people tend to forget their password, or, you know, you get it lost. So with your phone, with having your phone number being verified on the platform, it's usually very easy to, you know, recover them. Then enhanced verification, it's also there. Enhanced verification account withdraw greater than 50,000 USD or equivalent per day. Okay, I haven't actually done this because I had to submit some of my international passport and other, you know, identities. So, but one most important thing, you know, you just have to do on this settings area or section is this two-factor authentication. This two-factor, I know a lot of people out there basically don't know what this two-factor authentication means. Two-factor authentication, it's actually, you know, let's just call it a system that allows you to verify your, you know, your Bittrex account by two ways or two means. You know, it's not just that, you know, they're gonna send a mail to your mailbox, then you click on the link and then have your account verified. No, two-factor authentication is like, it's a way you can actually verify your Bittrex account by using your mobile phones, Google Authenticator, or any other authenticator out there in the market, so that whenever you want to log into your account, after inputting your password, after, you know, putting your username and your password, it will still request for a digit, like six digital codes. Like you're saying, input your six-digit authenticator code. Yeah. So this two-digit authenticator code would actually be sent into the authenticator application you've downloaded on your phone. And it's very, very easy to do. All you have to do is go to Google Play Store. If you want to do this, go to Google Play Store. This is Google Play Store. When you go to your Google Play Store, ensure you download Google Authenticator. Google Authenticator app. Yeah. This is the Google Authenticator app. This is the most, used out there in the market. Aside Google Authenticator, there are other types of authenticator in the market. But for me, I prefer using the Google Authenticator because it's very, very secure and it's trusted, you know, and it has 5-star rating on Google Drive. So you just want to download this application to your phone, and after downloading it, here is my phone. This is the Google Authenticator app. So whenever you want to log into your account, it's gonna like tell you to, it's gonna generate a new code, you know, a new code on its own. So when it generates the new code, you're just gonna type it into the you know, the input form there, and then you just easily log into your account. There are actually, you know, different reasons why people trust this two-factor authentication process. You know, in my next video, I think I'm going to be showing you a complete, you know, process of how you are going to do this. It's actually very simple, but for those of us who are not, you know, IT expert, or you don't really know anything in the ICT industry, it's very, very easy. I'm just going to start the whole process from the beginning to the end in subsequent video. Not just my next video, I'm going to do that so that you can actually understand how the simplicity and how it works. So the benefit of this, you know, two-factor authentication is this. Should your laptop get stolen, or your computer, you know, somehow, some way, you don't, somebody gets access to your computer, and maybe you've saved this password on your desktop. So somebody just, you know, bashes into your computer and, you know, wants to log into this account. Of course, you may not know, people can be so different, you know. So it's gonna like request after the password, you know, has been, you know, of course saved there. So it's gonna like open another page with an input asking you to put in or to type in this 6-digit authenticator code that the Google Authenticator app has already generated on your mobile application on your phone. So when you type in this code, it's just gonna like open. So when people get to, you know, access your computer without your consent, and then they perhaps scale to the first login process, it will be difficult for them to continue the login process because, you know, they don't have your phone, they don't know this authenticator, they are not sure which of your mobile phones the authenticator app has been, you know, installed, you know, something like that. So it's gonna be like very difficult for them to do that. And let's assume you are on the way on the highway and some guys just, you know hijacked your car, your bus, and stole your laptop. You are actually gonna be on the safer side because they will not be knowing your password. So it's difficult for them to actually hack into your, you know, your Bitrust account to steal your money. So this is the most important thing I'm sure you would wanna do if you want to use the Bittrex platform. Not just the Bittrex exchange, but every other exchange out there. Ensure you use your two-factor authenticator. As you can see on my Google authenticator, I have codes for different exchanges. I have Amazon authenticator here. I have Bittrex. I have liquid.io. I have the blockchain.info authenticator. So it's usually very, very good to do this because you can be less assured that your money, your cryptocurrencies are very secure. So having said that, the second thing you would want to do when you get to the Bittrex.com platform as a trader is to understand the other section. I click on the other section of my Bittrex account. Yeah, this shows you this opens and shows you, like, you know, the information everything you need, or the orders you've made, like, you know, like your withdrawals, your purchases, and all of this. You can see open orders, closed orders. These are the most important things she shows you, so that you can remember the day you bought, the day you sold, the number of cryptocurrency, the unit of the cryptocurrency you purchased, the unit you sold. So this is more like an archive of all your transactions. For traders who trade, you know, like mostly often, you're gonna like find all the informations here, and they are all, you know, categorized following the market, the date of transaction, the type of transaction you made, whether you bought or you sold, bid and ask price, the units, and so on and so forth. So it's more like an archive of every transaction you made on the Bittrex.com platform. So having said this, we're gonna move down to the wallet section. So when you click on the wallet section, I'm sorry, I'm gonna be like, you know, concealing some of this information here because this has to do with my private you know, information. I'm gonna be concealing some of this information here. So this actually shows you the number of, you know, transactions, the number, the amount of cryptocurrency you have, you know, accumulated, you know, in the long run, you know, during your whole trading session. So over here you can find Ripple, you can find Monero, you can find Bitcoin, ETC, Ethereum Classic, BitShares, Siacoin, Podcoin, and you can actually come back to the second page, Bust, XLM, the Stellar Lumens, the Verge Coin, NXT, Litecoin, and so on and so forth. So basically, on this wallet section, we have over 200 to 300 pages here on the Bittrex.com platform. These 300 pages actually contains the whole cryptocurrencies that that people are freely, you know, permitted to trade on the Bittrex.com platform. So which means if you can find any cryptocurrency on the major, you know, coin market cap, you know, market market capitalization and listing for the cryptocurrency platform, If you can find any cryptocurrency on coinmarketcap.com, and of course we have over 600 to 800, you know, cryptocurrencies here. So if you cannot find any of these cryptocurrencies, for example, BOBA is a cryptocurrency and it is ranking 707 on coinmarketcap. If you come to your My Wallet session and you paste this BOBA, as you can see, it is showing you that no matching records were found here. This actually means that, you know, Bittrex.com hasn't, you know, added this cryptocurrency to its platform, which means that traders cannot actually trade this cryptocurrency BOBA on the Bittrex platform, you know, for Bitcoin on the Bittrex platform. So any cryptocurrency you search here and you are not finding it on the Bittrex platform, so it's easier to understand that Bittrex hasn't added it. So if you want to trade on that currency and you don't know, you know, the exchange or what exchange to use to trade that particular currency, and you are interested in it, it's as simple as ABC. You found the information here, BOBA, and it's ranking 707 on the CoinMarketCap platform. So what you need to do is just left click, open in a new tab. Yeah, so when it opens in a new tab, just come down here, market, and when you click on market, you easily find the exchange from where you can actually buy or sell this cryptocurrency. And it's unfortunately that it's only one, you know, only one major exchange has this coin added to their database, and the name of that exchange is Yobit.com. So you can actually, you know, trace this Yobit.com using your Google search engine, Yahoo, and so on and so forth. So you can actually trace this Yobit.com major exchange, and then you can actually sign up there and you know, send some bitcoins there and, you know, trade your BioBytes coin. So that's all for that. Still on the My Wallet section of your Bittrex.com account, there is one more thing that's very important here that a whole lot of people find, you know, confusing or complicated. And this is the sign and the minus sign here. So, for example, this minus sign means if you want to, for example, this is Ripple, this cryptocurrency is Ripple, and you want to, you know, add some Ripple. Someone wants to send you some Ripple. You have a good friend who loves you so much and feels like, oh, my friend, today I'm going to, like, you know, give you some free gift. And that free gift has to be Ripples. I want to give you like 5,000 free gifts, 5,000 Ripples. I want to send you like 2,000 Ripples. You know, it's as easy as that. So what you need to do is just go to your Bittrex.com platform, click on this plus sign, and wait for an address to be generated here. So when that address is generated here, you just, you know, of course you want to wait for some minutes or some seconds for the address to appear here. So when this address appears here, all you would want to do is, you know, copy this address. When you copy it, or you click on new address, for example, it's not coming and you're waiting for a long time, it's not coming. So it's, as you can see, I've just clicked on that new address, and I'm just gonna, like, copy this address and send it via email or text message to my friend who wants to, you know, give me a free gift of 5,000 Ripples. So when you send this address to them, it's actually your wallet address. And of course you can see what it's telling you here. If the tag is not included in your transfer, we cannot credit your account. Please do not directly deposit from exchange or pool unless they allow you to specify a tag. Now, it is highlighting a very important information here, telling you that depositing tokens to this address other than XRP, which stands for Ripples, the Ripples token, will result in your funds being lost. So, of course, you would want to send, you know, only a Ripple address to your friend who wants to send you Ripples. And on the other hand, if your friend intends not to send you Ripples but decides to send you some, you know, few units of Monero, all you just have to do is to come down again to Monero, click on the plus sign, generate a new address, copy it, the address, and then send it to your friend via email, text message, or whichever way it's gonna be easier and convenient for you to convey this message. So your friend will actually send that the unit or maybe 5,000, 10,000, the same quantity of cryptocurrency that he wants to give you straight directly into this this address here. So, and then if your friend sends it, you'll get the alert or the update within a very, very short period of time. And that's how simple it is. And then on the same vein, if you wish to send to your friend this time around, not like your friend is sending you, or your friend sent you like 5,000 units of Ripples some weeks ago, and you decided that you were gonna like help him this time around by sending him, 5 units of Ethereum Classic. So you're gonna just like, you just wanna click this minus sign here. When you click the minus sign here, you're gonna like collect his own wallet ID. You just have to like impute his wallet ID here and then send the money to him. It's as simple as that. You impute the address here, you control paste it here. You get his address, you control paste it here, then you impute the number of cryptocurrency you feel like sending to him. If it is 100, you impute 100. If it is 1,000, if it is 2,000, depending on the number of cryptocurrency you want to send to him, and also depending on the number of cryptocurrency that you have at hand. Of course, you wouldn't want to send 2,000 cryptocurrency units of Ethereum Classic when you have just 1,000 units of Ethereum Classic in your wallet. So you tend to send below what you have, or exactly what you have. That's how it works. So don't tend to send above what you have. Of course, it's not gonna process if you do that. So that's all for that. And the third most important thing you need to know now is, of course, we've spoken about the other area, understanding what the wallet section works for, and then the plus and the minus signs. You would also want to care much about, we talked about wallet ID and then that's on. The last but not the least is, remembering to log out, each time you're done with, any transaction you're making. Of course, if you don't remember to log out, it's quite correct that your session expires on the Bittrex platform. For example, after 20 minutes of, being inactive on the platform, the session, the website automatically logs you out, and then would require, a password and, of course, your two-factor authentication code before you can, regain, permission onto the platform. So, but if you are opportune to be living among friends, maybe in the hostel where you have your own personal laptops, and of course you can't trust your friends, so you will always want to log out, of course. So if you want to go to somewhere and you're working on the Bittrex platform and you intend to go out, perhaps to go get something from the grocery store, you just have to remember to log out so that people don't just, or your friend does not just, won't just, come on to your system, assess your account, perhaps do something you wouldn't like there. So remembering the logout area, it's important. Just don't forget to log out, since you can remember to log in because you want to work, of course you want to do some trade, you want to earn some money. Since you could remember to log into your account, your Bittrex platform, it is always very, very important to always log out. But if you're living alone in your house, whether you are living alone in your house or you're not living alone in your home, it's just very important to remember to log out. Because, cryptocurrency is money. So the security should be very, very tight. Of course, no one wants to lose anything. So even if it is $1 that you're losing, it's as a trader, as an experienced trader, as a trader with, with prospects of becoming bigger, with potential, you shouldn't just, allow every bit of unit of cryptocurrency you have to get lost. You know, you should be very, very, you know, security conscious. You know, and to be security conscious, you should always remember your password. You should always remember to, you know, enable your two-factor authentication. You should always remember to trade when the time is right. If possible, make research before you trade. You know, all these things are, you know, most important. They are just most important. So at this juncture, I'll be rounding up this short video. So in the next, in subsequent videos, I'll be talking more about trading, you know, how you can actually get started, how you can, you know, figure out the most important coins to purchase or to trade or to invest on, and then 5 to 4 to 3 ways you can actually make big money with cryptocurrencies. Because it's not just all about buying and selling of these cryptocurrencies. It's not all about just, you know, buying them and accumulating them, you know, for a later time when the prices go up, then you can now sell and make some massive earnings. No, it's not like that. There are also, you know, other lucrative ways you can make money from cryptocurrency, especially if you are in the field of ICT, or especially if you are hungry for ICT. Yeah, because people who are passionate about ICT too can actually learn to become better than those that have been in the field, you know, for years. So thank you guys. In my next video, I'll be talking more. Remember to come back. This is remember to subscribe, please. Try and subscribe to my channel, because my channel is still an infant channel, so it's still growing. Remember to subscribe, remember to, you know, like, remember to ask any question you think, you know, regarding anything you feel is bothering you. Just leave a comment below, and if there is something I can't actually help you with, I'll refer you to some of my friends who have been doing this for years and understand, you know, everything about, you know, cryptocurrency. Thank you.